So experiential mindfulness activities. This first slide here is something I actually created special for this presentation. This is stuff that I talk about in my sessions with clients, but I felt like it would be a really good idea to put it into words. So this is something that I recommend that you can print out and put it in your pocket or take a picture of it on your phone, save it on your computer or cell phone. And it's about mindfulness of physical pain and breaking down what you can do when you're in a heightened pain moment. So the P is about pursuing the present moment. Breathe slowly and deeply. Notice the colors and objects and noises around you. A is about allowing yourself to lean into your pain, make room for it, acknowledge its presence. Remember, when we ignore or distract from our pain, we can only do this for so long before pain intensity heightens. I is interview your experience. Be inquisitive. Am I experiencing stabbing pain, lightning pain? Am I feeling sad? Am I frustrated? And then N is about now. Act on your values. Values are the things that we care most about in life, such as self-care, relationships, and creativity. In this moment, should you use a heating pad, color a mandala, talk with a loved one, pet your dog, cuddle up with a blanket and a movie, read a book, those sort of things. And so now together we're going to engage in a mindfulness activity that's a formal mindfulness activity of your breath and sound. And it's about 2 minutes or so. And so I just wanted to give an example of what a formal one looks like. So let's go ahead and start by making sure that your body is properly supported. That may be done by using a pillow to support your lumbar region or by leaning against a chair or a couch. Loosen any restricting clothing. Make sure your arms and legs are uncrossed. And if you are comfortable, go ahead and close your eyes. If not, gaze at one object in front of you. So I'd like us to start by just noticing your breathing. Know that there is nothing else for you to do, nowhere else for you to be, except right here, right now, taking care of yourself in this moment. And any time that thoughts come up that don't relate to this activity, notice those thoughts and then bring yourself back to your breath, back to my voice. And as you breathe slowly and deeply, bring your attention to the tip of your nose. You may notice the sensation of air moving in and out of your nostrils as you slowly breathe. You may also notice that the air coming in through your nostrils may feel slightly cooler than the air moving out of your nostrils. You may also notice the rise and fall of your stomach or chest as you breathe. And as you continue to breathe slowly, go ahead and open your ears. Become aware of the sounds around you. Perhaps you hear distant talking, traffic, the sound of a heater, air conditioner, or fan. Maybe you hear birds singing or music playing. Or maybe where you are it is quiet and you only hear the sound of my voice. Allow yourself to notice each of the sounds around you, bringing your attention from one sound to another. It's not time to judge if these sounds are pleasant or not. It's just about noticing the sound. So let's go ahead and take the next few moments of silence to focus on the sounds around you. And it may be beneficial for you to focus on just one sound. And again, as we take this time of silence, any thoughts that come up that do not relate to listening, go ahead and notice those thoughts and then return to your breath and sound. Now I would like you to release your attention to sound and return your attention to your breathing. As you notice your breathing, also begin to notice the environment around you, where you are sitting, the chair beneath you, your feet on the ground or in elevated position. And when you are ready, take another slow, deep breath and open your eyes and return to the room. So I'd like you to go ahead and take note of your mindfulness experience. And remember that there are many types of ways you can cultivate mindfulness. It's about finding the ways that best connect with you. So I have two final thoughts before I end today. The first is to be a self-advocate, my fellow pain warriors, and join other pain warriors because you are certainly not alone. You are not weak because of your illness. You did not feel treatment. The treatments failed you. Your illness is not your fault. You did not cause this. You are not a failure. You are a warrior. And then another quote, fate whispers to the warrior, you cannot withstand the storm. And the warrior whispers back, I am the storm. So go ahead and start right where you are. You don't have to have it all figured out to move forward. There's no wrong way to engage in mindfulness. It's just about beginning. And I incorporated in this presentation some of the references that are throughout, as well as additional suggested mindfulness readings, if you're interested, and also the workbook on chronic pain and mindfulness is also in this list. So I'd like to go ahead and thank you all for joining today. I hope that this was of benefit to everyone, and I'd like to thank Barbie and the International Pain Foundation for inviting me to speak today. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. That was such a great presentation, and I'm glad that you do have an extra few minutes because I know people have some questions. I'm going to ask you a few questions. I'm so relaxed from doing that exercise. I'm going to ask you a few questions that were pre-submitted, and then I'm going to open it up to questions and answers. So the first one is from Eileen in Metairie, Louisiana. I think I said that correctly. I'm not sure. How can you help someone with anxiety when it starts, when they both people have chronic pain, but the person that's trying to help doesn't experience the same anxiety, even though they're both going through similar chronic pain diseases?
Great. Well, thank you, Eileen, for posing that question. First, I would suggest definitely to print out my mindfulness of physical pain slide and share it with your friend. I think that would be very beneficial for her and for you in the moment to help guide her. And I think the best way to help your friend with her when her anxiety starts is to assist her in engaging in grounding techniques. This can be done by using your five senses. So point out colors in the room, items in the room, have her hold your hand or feel her shirt or any jewelry and such. What this does is it allows her mind to begin to slow down because it takes mental energy to divert focus onto things that are going on around her instead of just the things that are going on inside of her. I also recommend breathing slowly with her. Counting out loud with breaths can also help. So that might be something like breathing in, hold one, two, breathing out. Hold one, two. Something like that would be really beneficial in the moment. So thank you for your question.
Great answer. Next came from Scarlett in Windsor, Ontario, Canada. And she asks, how do you truly deal with such chronic pain and move forward in life? I know that's a big question, but if you could just give a couple of suggestions, that'd be great.
Definitely. This webinar definitely discusses the beginning ways one can start to move forward. However, it's definitely a process that involves caring for oneself on a biopsychosocial spiritual level, so definitely external assistance is needed. I always suggest that people can go online or ask around locally to find a clinical health psychologist or a rehabilitation psychologist who specializes in chronic pain and chronic illness. not all therapists are equal, and not every therapist has training in chronic pain, so it's best to find someone who does. And also know that psychologists are different from psychiatrists. As psychologists provide psychotherapy, although some do prescribe medication, but psychologists also help patients learn coping skills and how to live life with pain, while psychiatrists focus mostly on administering medication and their medical doctors. I also highly suggest the workbook that I had mentioned before, Living Beyond Your Pain, Using Acceptance and Commitment Therapy to Ease Chronic Pain. This is a phenomenal workbook that can start to help a person really learn how to deal with chronic pain while still living their values. So thank you, Scarlett, for asking that question.
Patricia in of Heathmont, State of Victoria in Australia, asks, what links exist between practicing mindful meditation and neuroplasticity of the brain or the ability to reprogram the brain in relation to chronic pain?
Thank you, Patricia, for that question. So there are numerous studies on mindfulness and neuroplasticity, as well as studies directly addressing chronic pain. Some studies suggest that even 5 minutes of mindfulness a day, whether it's informal or not, can eventually rewire brain signals. So it's, again, that concept of being able to, when a pain flare occurs, being able to attend to yourself and take care of yourself, and then come back to the present moment and engage in your values. So to learn more about this, because it's such a broad topic that I wouldn't be able to do it justice answering it in a short question, I definitely recommend the CDs, The Mindful Brain, The Neurobiology of Well-Being by Dr. Daniel Siegel. You can actually also subscribe to his YouTube channel where he posts many videos on this topic. And another prominent doctor in the field is Dr. Jon Kabat-Zinn. He has numerous books and articles and YouTube discussions on this topic, and I also listed some of his books in the resource section of this webinar.
Dr. Geraghty, I really appreciate it. I'd like to thank you for being such a great guest and an amazing, caring doctor who really gets your patients because, as you said, you have so many medical conditions yourself that all deal with chronic pain that you know what it's like to live with the challenges that we live with. And you can find more information on Dr. Geraghty at facebook.com/mindfulmoments by Dr. G. Again, facebook.com/mindfulmoments by Dr. G. On Twitter, she is at mindfuldrg, and Dr. is D-R. So don't spell Dr. all the way out on both Facebook and Twitter, DRG, Dr. G. And appreciate everybody for being here. Our next webinar is the second part to this mindfulness series, and it's on alternative treatments to depression. And the guest is Dr. Karen Cassidy. And that will be on Friday, May 13th at 1 p.m. Central Time. And we also have in May Safe Medication Practices for Chronic Pain Patients by pharmacist Tom Kelly, and that is on Monday, May 23rd at 6 p.m. Eastern, and you can go to our website and RCP for those, as well as come back and listen to the past webinars that we've had on mindfulness, stem cell therapy, and oral orthotics, neuroinflammation, and TMD. And again, you can check us out on social media, facebook.com/powerofpain, and on Twitter at powerofpain. Again, thank you everybody who attended today, and we look forward to having you at one of our future webinars. Thank you very much from the International Pain Foundation.